Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Ken Jones. I'll be the moderator for this panel. And
speak right into the mic.
Okay. So the panel, as you can see from your program, is about the Asia-Pacific pivot, resistance to missile offense, radars, and interceptors. On the program, there are three presenters. Unfortunately, Tiara Lahuti was unable to come. Her flight was canceled, so she wasn't able to make the meeting. So we have two presenters, one of which, who will speak first, is the Reverend Seung-hae Kim, who is the co-chair of the Seongju Struggle Committee to stop the THAAD deployment in South Korea. The U.S. is currently deploying the THAAD MD system in her community, and daily protests have been going on for months. Our other speaker, and her translator will be Julian Lee, who is sitting over there. our second speaker is Mr. Yasuo Ogata, who is the co-chair of the World Conference Against A and H Bombs and former member of Parliament, Upper House, Japan. He recently attended the Global Network Space Conference in India. Before we start, we're going to have a song from Jason Brown from State of Maine.
Hello, it's really excellent to be here among such excellent people. A lot of the change that's happening in favor of life on the planet is happening around the world because of people like us, so I'm really happy to be here with all of you. I feel that I owe some specific gratitude to friends in Korea and friends in Okinawa because those were the first places that I had ever visited where I've been part of a resistance community that had existed. That had been in existence for a long time, too long, we could say. But I have so much gratitude for the people who are fighting death and destruction around the whole planet. So thank you, Kumaksumida, Hanguk Saram Chingu, and Arigato Gozaimasu, Nihonjin Tomodachi. This is a song that I learned in. On Jeju Island, and it was the theme song of their peace walk a few years ago, and it was written by Song Yohan, who is some kind of a priest. I don't know what kind of a good priest. Excellent. And the title of the song is Nanun Bandeda, and it means I'm against it, and it's talking about the war base there. I don't have my guitar, so I can't find the note.
Kangjong appada dogorega Marul omheso kuruchi Nalun bandeda chose bandeda Hegungichi bandeda Godunganun bandeda 멸치도 반대다 우노도 저대 반대다 노그레는 반대다 곧게도 반대다 해군기지 반대다 강정 앞바다
It doesn't do this when I'm at home.
강정 앞바다 돌고래가 말을 엄해서 그렇지 나는 반대다 저대 반대다 해군기지 반대다 구름비는 반대다 하늘산도 반대다 범성도 저대 반대다 유출봉도 반대다 고추어도 반대다 해군기지 반대다 해군기지 반대다 bandeda, fat bande.
Thank you. Jason, thank you. Okay, so the idea is that each of our speakers will have 15 minutes or so, maybe a little more since our third speaker isn't here, and then we'll have questions and answers. So first, Reverend Kim.
Hello, nice to meet you. I am not speaking English. Sorry.
It's okay. I speak on behalf of our translator.
Yeah, 저는 South Korea에 live in 성주. 저는 성주에 살고 있습니다. 그런데 거기에 사드가 지난 7월 13일 날 들어온다는 국가의 너무 갑작스러운 발표에 대해서 제가 놀랐습니다.
So in July 13 last year, we were suddenly. We were told that the Fed is going to come into our own town, Seongju, South Korea.
사드가 성주에 온다는 것을 지금 대통령 저기를 맡고 있는 황교안이가 설명하러 왔을 때 우리 성주 국민이 다 모였습니다.
So the thing is about the Hwang Kyo-won, who is an acting president right now at this point. He came to explain about the goodness and benefits of the Fed. A deployment in Seongju, and everyone gathered to hear him.
사드가 우리 인체에 해롭지 않고 좋다는 것을 설명하자마자
And he said that is really not harmful to the people, and it's really good for the environment.
계란 세례와 물 세례를 했습니다.
People responded with an accent and throwing the water bottles to him.
그리고 8월 15일이 되는 날은 저희 대한민국의 광복절인데 그날 우리 성주 국민들은 결의를 다지는 뜻으로 사드를 반대하는 뜻으로 머리 삭발식을 했습니다.
On August 15th is the Liberation Day for Korea from the Japanese colonization. On that day, to commemorate the 815, August 15th, we gathered 815 volunteers, but actually 907 people volunteered to shave their head off.
한 명이 삭발하기도 어려운 것인데 그날 결의를 다지는 뜻으로 908명이라는 사람이 함께 모여서 삭발을 했습니다.
In Korean tradition, it is really hard to shave your head off. That means a lot. But 908 people actually shaved their head off on that ceremony.
이렇게 머리를 깎는다는 것은 조상이 물려준 내 몸이기 때문에 상당한 결의, 그러니까 죽기로서 사드를 막아나겠다는 그런 결의를 다진 것입니다.
So shaving the head hair, all the hair means that you know it's cutting off or destroying the body that was given by the ancestor down to me. It means that your conviction is beyond your own death.
그리고 매일매일 하루도 빠짐없이 저희 마을에 살고 있는 분들이 1,500명 정도가 모여서 촛불로서 시위를 했습니다. 사드는 안 된다고.
Every day, without missing a day, 1,500 people from the town gathered every night, and we held a candlelight in protest of that deployment.
그리고 거기 사는 주민들은 이렇게 자기 직업도 내팽개친 채 그렇게 시위를 전국을 돌아다니면서 사드가 들어오면 안 된다는 것을 알리기 시작했습니다.
And people, some people gave up their livelihood. They gave up their own day jobs, and then they went on to the national tour with the sandwich board, saying that we are opposing the Fed deployment.
그러한 촛불들이 모여져서 많은 사람들이 모여 반대를 하는 도중에 금수가 그 사드 반대하겠다는 그 지역, 놓겠다는 그 지역에서 좀 떨어진 곳으로 사드 배치 장소로 옮겼습니다.
So the government responded to switching the town. So at first it was the most appropriate town was Songju, they announced. And then when people were resisting, they said, okay, they found another place. So right next to the town of the Songju, they changed the site, deployment site.
그곳은 바로 김천 시민이 살고 있는, 14만 시민이 살고 있는 혁신 도시를 바라보는 레이더가 그쪽을 향한 곳이었습니다.
And the site they chose is towards the Gimcheon city, that's a, which is an innovative city that was created by the government design for education of young people. 140,000 people reside.
그날부터 성주와 성주는 성주에서 촛불을 들고 김천 시민은 김천에서 촛불을 들기 시작해서 촛불을 든 시위 장소가 두 군데가 됐습니다.
So from that day on, the residents of the Gimcheon city also participated in the candlelight vigil. There was a two candlelight vigils happening every night.
김천은 젊은 엄마들이 많이 살았기 때문에 넘기고요. 아이들과 함께 늘 시위를 했습니다.
Gimcheon has a lot of young moms with the young children. So the old young moms came with their children to the candlelight vigil.
어린이, 학생, 청년 모두가 다 함께 그 지역에 사는 사람들은 사드는 싫다고 반대를 했습니다.
So that includes from the children, students, youth, and elderly. Everyone was participating in this SAD rally.
그래서 저희들은 그 사드를 배치하겠다는 국가의 정치 새누리당을 개누리당이라고 부르면서 장례식을 치렀습니다.
So the Songju and Gimcheon comprised of the people population who supports the government. They vote like 99% has been voting for the ruling party. They gave up their support towards the ruling party, which did not do anything for them. They did a funeral concession, mock funeral concession of all the ruling party in their ceremonies.
이것은 그 상여가 나가는 모습입니다.
So that is when the coffin is going out of the town.
그리고 나서 저희들은 평화의 발걸음을 했습니다. 사드는 가고 평화는 오라고 많은 시민과 함께 걸음걸음이 알리는 그러한 행사들, 퍼포먼스를 했습니다.
So in one of those days, people did steps for the peace. When the SAD should go away to the U.S., but the come the peace to the Korean Peninsula.
그리고 저는 원불교 교무인데 우리 원불교 교무님들이 다 같이 일어나서 평화의 기도를 올렸습니다. 광화문 광장에서.
This is at Gwanghwamun Plaza at the center of the city, Seoul City. I am a minister at Wonburgyo, One Buddhism. And all the ministers got together at the Seoul, and we did a prayer meeting for against the SAD deployment.
그리고 또 모여서 가끔씩은 전체가 모여서 사드는 안 된다고 저희들이 외쳤습니다.
We are saying that you know the SAD deployment should not happen in entire Korean Peninsula. That's what we do sometimes, you know, occasionally. Along with every believers of the One Buddhism.
왜 사드가 여기는 저희도 국방부 앞에서 원불교 교무와 교도들은 전체가 매일매일 오후 2시부터 저녁 6시 퇴근 시간까지 기도회를 열었습니다.
Every day, some of the ministers went to the defense ministry and they did a prayer meeting, sit-ins from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m.
이 국방부는 저희한테 한마디 상의도 없이 미국하고 둘이 몰래 사드를 갖다 놓기로 약속을 했던 것입니다.
Defense Ministry when really undemocratically decided, unilaterally decided the third deployment only in consultation with the U.S. government. They didn't say anything to the Korean government, Korean people.
이거는 국가와 국가의 약속도 아니었고 박근혜 위에 있는 최순실의 그냥 개인적으로 무기 회사하고 했던 약속이었습니다.
We take it as not as a promise or agreement between the government, country to country, but it was more to a lobbyist to the military industrial complex or Raytheon or Lockheed Martin.
그래서 저희 1,600만 시민들이 일어나서 촛불 시위를 광화문에서 그리고 청와대 주변에서 토요일마다 하게 되었습니다.
Against the government's scandal, and about 16 million people gathered every Saturday to call for impeachment of a president in Seoul, Gwanghwamun Plaza, just like this. 16 million.
이렇게 광화문에서 촛불 시위 할 때마다 버스를 대절해서 올라가서 저도 이 광화문 광장에서 발언을 했습니다.
So, 성주 citizens also went up every Saturday to participate in this candlelight vigil, and I also spoke against all these people, towards all these people about the 성주 third deployment.
박근혜를 하야하라고 할 때까지만 해도 사드 문제는 그렇게 크게 뉴스에서 다루어지지 않았습니다.
Until the impeachment of the 박근혜 president, ex-president right now, that was not really on the radar of the older people.
박근혜가 하야한 다음에 내려온 다음에 이제 사드 문제가 조금씩 드러나기 시작했습니다.
After the 박근혜's impeachment was completed and the people were now considering that as a next urgent issue.
지난 3월 18일에 저희 소성이라는 조그만 마을에 70가구밖에 안 사는데 그곳에 5,000명이 모여서 사드 반대 집회를 열었습니다.
On the last March 18th, Soseong Li, which is going to be the target city, the target town, where 70 households reside currently, 5,000 people gathered to join this protest.
사드 가면 평화 온다는 그러한 외침을 하면서 계속 평화의 발걸음을 하고 있습니다.
We say when Saad goes, peace will come is our slogan right now. And we are continuing our efforts to stand up against that deployment.
이렇게 매일 소송리에 모이는 것은 지난 2월 28일 날 롯데 컨트리클럽과 국방부가 부지기환을 해서 컨트리클럽에 사드를 갖다 놓겠다고 발표한 이후부터는 매일 모입니다.
This solidarity visits were happening now on a daily basis ever since the February 28th, the land swap with the Defense Ministry and Lotte Country Club golf course happened. We were expecting that that's not gonna happen because of our strong resistance, but it happened. And now we are feeling a little more urgency in doing this. And people have been visiting every single day ever since.
사드가 온다는 것을 알리기 위해서 두 명의 마라토너가 소성리에서부터 서울 광화문까지 일주일간 매일 뛰었습니다.
So one of the promoting activity, there was a peace marathon where these two people ran from Songju to Seoul for 7 days straight.
그 후에 국방부에서는 그 지질 검사를 하겠다고 계속 작업을 시작하고 있는데 저희들이 나서서 온몸으로 그 작업을 막고 있습니다. 길을.
So the defense ministry, the next step is a land surveying. So in order to stop that cars to come into the village, people have been really blocking with their own body the road towards the golf course.
저희가 평화롭게 살고 있던 조그마한 마을에 경찰이 2,000명이 넘게 배치되어 있고 군인이 2,000명이 넘게 배치되어 있는 아주 살벌한 마을이 됐습니다.
Our town was a very peaceful town with only a little over 250 people. The Soseong-ri is the town, a very small village. And now we have more than 2,000 policemen and more than 2,000 military.
그곳에 살고 계신 우리 할머니들은 늘 불안해하고 공포에 쌓여 있습니다.
The grandmas living in this Soseong-ri is always agitated and living in a kind of fear.
그냥 편안하게 평소처럼 살다가 죽고 싶다고 그러면서 내 자손들한테 그대로 이 땅을 물려주고 싶다고 이야기합니다.
They want to be able to leave this land to the next generation as it is and as it has been all the time.
그래서 저희들은 그 골부장 사드가 들어갈 수 있는 그 길을 저희 원불교에서 한 20일 전부터는 길을 막고 완전히 연좌 농성을 벌이고 있습니다. 24시간 동안.
So from the 20 days ago, the one Buddhists are doing a sitting for 24 hours a day in the main road towards the golf course.
이거는 밤의 모습이고.
This is the nighttime.
예, 이곳은 낮의 모습입니다.
This is the daytime.
밤낮 없이 지키고 있는 이유는 이 길을 터달라고 하는 것입니다. 왜냐하면 이 길은 저희 스승님이 도를 위해서 스승을 찾아서 걸어가신 구독길입니다.
The reason that we are doing this sitting is because the military is now blocking and not allowing the villagers and the one Buddhists to go up anymore, claiming that this is the military land now. But this is a passage of enlightenment that we have been walking every single day because one Buddhist headmaster had walked and this is a sacred holy ground for us.
그리고 국회에 가서도 민주당사에 저희 이 사드 배치를 철회하게 해달라고 당론으로 채택해달라고 농성을 며칠간 밤새워서 했습니다.
Not only doing the sittings and rallies and candlelight vigils, but we also visited this political party, the Winter-Min, the Democratic Political Party's house, the building, and went to demand that they would adopt this policy against the THAAD deployment, and we did a whole day rally there too.
며칠 전에는 저희 원불교의 4대 종교, 그러니까 종교인들이 나서서 사드를 막겠다고 수장들이 찾아오셨습니다.
These are the leaders of four main religions in Korea. Finally, they all decided to join in and then do it together in solidarity, joining this fight against that deployment in Songju.
그래서 저희 원불교에서 이렇게 더 나서는 것은 저희 스승님이신 성자가 태어나신 고향입니다. 그래서 사드와 성자의 고향, 영성을 회복할 수 있는 그러한 곳에 전쟁 무기와 스승은 함께 공존할 수 없다고 생각합니다.
So the Songju is a really special city for one Buddhists. It's the birthplace for our second headmaster, head Dharma master. And because it's a holy ground for us, we don't think that it can coexist with that, especially the weapon of war, in the same place.
저희 스승님은 말씀하셨습니다. 온 한우란 한이치에, 한 집안 한 권숙이 한 일터 한 일꾼으로 이런 세계를 건설한다고. 그러니까 종교의 전쟁을 막고 또 이념의 전쟁을 막고 모든 일이 하나이기 때문에 모두가 평화의 세계를 건설해야 된다고 말씀하셨습니다. 말씀하셨고 그렇게 실천하는 종교입니다.
The teachings of him specially emphasize on the oneness of the religion, oneness of the people regardless of the races, and oneness of the people regardless of political ideology. That since we came from the same place and we are going to the same place, we have to build a new place of the peace, and we work together to create a bigger harmony with the universe. That's the teaching. So that does not allow the weapons and killing machines to come into this holy ground.
예, 저희 스승님 말씀하셨습니다. 정의거든 죽기로서 행하라고. 그래서 저희들은 죽기를 각오하고 이 사드를 반대하고 전쟁기를 반대하고 있습니다.
So also, our religion started under the Japanese colonization, and he always taught us that if you see it, you believe it, this is the justice, then don't hesitate. Have no regrets in going forward, even if it means you're going to die.
평화를 사랑하는 여러분들 정말 존경합니다. 저희 도와주십시오. 감사합니다. Thank you very much.
I really have a high respect towards you, peace-loving citizens. And I really hope that we can work together and, you know, you will be helping us stopping the fab employment in Korea. Thank you very much.